the sight for the Timberwolves. The free-flowing D'Angelo Russell with no conscience scoring the basketball as they prepare for action at the Smoothie King Center. T-Wolves, Pelicans, tip-off coming up right after this. Just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Pass to Valanciunas. Now here's Ingram. And he's going for the oop here! Tipped! Here's Anderson. He's been productive, averaging just over 7 points a game. McDaniels from long range. He can't hit that time. And New Orleans will come the other way. This game against Minnesota is the first time they've met this year. Winning the season series last year in a battle of middle of the pack teams.
Yeah, there's no question, this guy. He just gives you great effort, and he continues to give you great production.
One thing you know, you will always get the balance. He's going to rebound. Offense, defense, no matter what, he's attacking the glass. The defense is nowhere to be found guarding the three-point shot.
And there's the foul. It's on Rudy Gobert. That's his first foul of the game.
Second team foul.
From the inbound. Drive to the hoop, courtesy of Mobile One.
Yeah, they're trying to close this gap. Always a good option to probe the paint to see if you can get an easy one inside. Man, they're having a hard time defending the triple. That's three in a row.
Now here's Williamson. A proven scorer in this league, averaging just over 25 a game. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
On the lower block, Valanciunas has shown that he can be a skilled offensive player, and the defense has got to pay attention to him. What a tremendous job playing to the contact.
And a chance for a moment to check out the scoring breakdown for the Timberwolves.
Yeah, their early focus on outside scoring has paid off. They're finding plenty of points from three-point land.
Yeah, and in addition, their ball movement has really unleashed their offense. Boy, they've been fun to watch.
McDaniels from long range. That falls. Nice assist by Russell. Russell's got 4 assists in the game. Ingram with the ball. He's picked up by Edwards. That one's good for two. Ingram's got his second bucket.
It's hard trying to match up with Ingram, especially when he's looking to score inside.
The three from Russell.
And another three from Minnesota.
All five of the last buckets they've given up have been from downtown.
The Pelicans shooting 33% in the first quarter. Pass to Daniels. Up and over Russell. Now in Junis. Second chance shot. Tries yet again. They have a number of cracks at it. Just came away empty-handed. For Minnesota, they've got 8 out of 12 shots to fall. McDaniels from long range.
Janney drains it. A solid 5-for-6 now. A dozen consecutive points off of threes. This defense looks rattled.
And here's Valanciunas. Blocked! And as it goes out of bounds, New Orleans will keep possession. Hayes is checked in for Williamson.
Into the lineup for your Pelicans! Jackson!
23 seconds left in the first quarter here. Pass to Daniels. The 11-footer. It's wide right, hits off the rim.
That's 2 points they should have had. I'm sure he'd love to get that look again.
Russell to pass to McDaniels. For three. And the Timberwolves hit again from deep.
They're not wasting any time putting their stamp on this game. What a start.
They've been doing it largely at the offensive end. If the defense does not adjust, this could be a blowout.
And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves. Feeling confident. 18-point lead to end that quarter. Boy, they've been playing at a fast pace, beating the defense in transition and adding to that big lead. Time for a quick break, then back to the action. Shooting just 24% on this one. Not great.
McCollum and Jones, the tandem in the backcourt. Jonas Valanciunas out there with Jackson Hayes. And it's Ingram in at the three. That's the Pelicans five. Back to Anderson. The three is up. They get it again. Oh, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
I'll tell you, with Rudy Gobert on the floor, you have got to find him and keep him off the glass because he can be a force.
So it's the Pelicans now. For three, McCollum. Tries again. Valanciunas, good. Valanciunas has got 6 points.
Good execution. They're getting some short-range looks here.
The three from Russell. Pure from three-point range.
They've been pretty lax with their perimeter defense, giving up a lot of three-pointers.
Well, you consider D'Angelo Russell and the fact that he's been a part of multiple organizations. Obviously, he has been a frequent trade piece. The one question is, can he stick with one franchise and establish some success?
Edwards, a pass to McDaniels. It's stolen by Ingram. Over Edwards. The shot by Ingram, no good.
Listen, simply put, he's got to finish that. It's not like the defender was right on top of him.
Count that one. Well, his trade activity says something about how desirable Russell is as a player.
I think he's a guy in that team could want on their roster because of his scoring capabilities. Very capable of huge nights in the NBA, but the other aspect that's so important is his ability as a setup guy.
The Pelicans making a switch here. Williamson's checked in. And the Timberwolves also making a change. Prince is checked in. McCollum passed to Jones. Williamson with it.
Oh, Williamson throws it down. Did you guys feel that? When Zion slams it, the floor shakes.
It's Edwards with a drive. And Edwards slams it in.
How about the assist coming off the deck? What a pretty bounce pass.
For New Orleans, they've got 3 of 6 shots to go here in the second quarter. And Gobert with a block.
Well, let's remember, Rudy Gobert has got a 7'9" wingspan. Sometimes it's just easy picking, sending it back. This guy just can't find his rhythm. And you look up at the scoreboard, they absolutely need his productivity.
And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Outside Ingram. And Gobert with a block. Russell against McCollum. Russell pass to Gobert. Here's Prince. Gobert.
This guy's so dangerous on the offensive glass, and you'll love to see him jam it home and leave no doubt.
Here's McCollum. We saw him with 19 his last time out. Outside Jones, to the inside. Now in Tunis, Minnesota with a rebound. Gobert's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. And Edwards, here we go.
And Edwards slams it in. This is legit showmanship right here. I mean, I'm a huge fan of the tomahawk there.
That's more than just getting 2 points. That was sending a clear message. You know, some have said those old school power forwards, guys like Charles Oakley, they're becoming outdated. You see that, Grant?
Well, first of all, the physicality in the game is no more.
The way Oakley would hit you and bruise you, you can't do that in today's game.
And guys like Oakley are now playing the five position, and they're shooting three-pointers. So a lot of it just is because the game has changed and evolved since the 90s when Oakley dominated.
Great skill level in the game right now, no question.
Great effort to turn the miss into 2 points.
Yes, sir. Those are the hustle points.
This guy is so explosive. Anthony Edwards off the bounce. My goodness.
Well, New Orleans shooting just 38% in this quarter. Here's McCollum. And the dunk by Valanciunas.
And this is something he does all too well. Great position for the putback there.
And I like how he doesn't think twice about passing it out. Just going right for the slam.
No reason to do so there. He was going to leave no doubt.
Down low. Here's Valanciunas. That's good. And it's McCollum with the assist. McCollum's got 3 assists tonight.
Boy, what a game it's been for Jonas Valanciunas. And has he had what the defense has thrown at him? He's continued to deliver on the offensive end.
And taking a look at this first half, they've just shown better shot selection.
And I think, obviously, we see the execution and the willingness to make the next pass so important.
Ingram, the pass to Valanciunas. And the dunk by Valanciunas.
Size and length to make it look easy.
Prince nails it from beyond the arc. Prince has got 5 points.
Such a reliable threat from range. You'd think the defense might key on him a little bit more.
From 11 feet away, Williamson passes to Valanciunas. And so he draws the foul back to the line to shoot a pair.
When Valanciunas forces an issue like that, he is really tough to handle. He does a good job drawing contact.
Rivers has checked in for Russell. Minnesota's gone 2 of 4 from the perimeter in the second so far. Shot and game clock separated by 5. And the whistle blows as the basket counts. Chance at a 3-point opportunity here. 1 free throw coming up. Nance, he's checked in for New Orleans. And the Pelicans shooting around 33%. Not the best offensive efficiency. To the middle. Here's Williamson. Nails the baby hook. Williamson's got 6 points in the quarter.
Boy, this guy has been terrific. The rest of the team, however, struggling.
And here's Edwards outside. And they get it back. Uses the glass on the layup.
You have to appreciate the doggedness and intensity on the glass. Wow.
Nance for 3. It's deflected.
Wow, great defensive play by Anthony Edwards. Engaged on that end of the floor right now.
And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves with a commanding lead to end the quarter. 27 points, looking good. Defense is setting the tone. More 2K action in just a moment.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
After one half of play, it's been a one-sided affair. Hey, everybody, welcome back. This is Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. It's Minnesota out in front at the half. They are completely in control of the game, leading by a massive amount. Kenny, how'd you see it?
Well, the bench came in and helped them run away from this tremendous job of getting loose, getting open, and thrilling shots. You always want that spark off the bench, and these guys delivered.
And over to the big fellas. Your thoughts on the Pelicans?
Definitely, they need to get out of the three-point shooter. They can test. This is what happens when another team identifies you.
And that does it for our halftime show. We now take you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third period.
Outside Jones. McCollum on the wing.
This one for three. Nails it from the
McCollum's got his second bucket of the night.
Off the pass, McCollum can be instantaneous. He doesn't think, he just shoots.
Prince can't hit. The Pelicans have got two of three from the floor in this third quarter. Outside Jones to the paint. An open look for Ingram. The rebound by the Timberwolves.
Yeah, you have to knock those down. Open shots inside the arc are rare in this league.
Russell finds Gobert.
Launches it.
And it's Russell. That time on the assist by Gobert.
For three.
Gobert's got six assists here tonight. Up top McCollum. Guarded by Edwards. Shot's good. Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
Yeah, a double-digit deficit. They're going to have to play better. They need more of this kind of aggressive play.
Oh, got that bucket in no time at all. Edwards has got 17.
Boy, excellent start to the second half. They've missed just once in five attempts.
Pass to Ingram. And he lobs it up to the rim. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by in the third quarter. Russell from outside, and the Timberwolves hit again from deep.
And the defense is really allowing them too much room on the perimeter.
Williamson passes to Ingram. Now McCollum. From 13, Rudy Gobert with a rebound. Gobert's got rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass.
Even on the years he's not winning Defensive Player of the Year, Rudy Gobert finds a way to finish in the top three. This is one of the most consistent elite defenders in the game.
Ingram with the ball. Now guarded by McDaniels. Offensive rebound.
Well, he's a quality mid-range shooter, but he can't get that one to go.
Russell, the pass to Gobert. Edwards with it. McDaniels from long range. And yes, it's good. He's 7 for 8 now. Endorsed with Gobert, it still feels like he doesn't get the credit he deserves.
And B.A., at this point, I find that inexcusable. You just watch the game and understand the metrics to see the massive impact that Rudy Gobert has on winning. It is not only on the defensive end either.
Russell from outside. And another three from Minnesota.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. Four of the last five buckets have been threes.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Here's Valanciunas. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. Rudy Gobert picks one up.
More of a traditional center. Jonas Valanciunas can dominate the glass and capable of a double-double on the end of the night.
And the first one at the line is good.
And in trading for Rudy Gobert, the Timberwolves taking a Twin Towers approach with 2 7-footers in their front court. Of course, the outstanding shooting of Karl Anthony Towns means that spacing shouldn't be much of a concern.
Pass to Edwards. Back to Russell. From deep three-point range. Gets the three ball to go. Russell's got 12 points here in the second half.
The assist numbers certainly stand out. They've really emphasized ball movement here today.
Here's Hayes. 2 points. That one goes.
Well, so great when your offense produces a shot that close to the rim. The rest of the work becomes easier.
Here's Noel. Count it.
Well, if you're going to play the point guard position, critical that D'Angelo Russell continue to develop that aspect of his game. Nice pass.
Pass to Daniels. From the baseline. That one rolls around and rims out. 4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Here's Edwards. And that one falls. Now 10 for 12 with that make.
What an aggressive mindset in this period. He's starting to take over.
From 8 feet, here's Valanciunas. And the dunk by Valanciunas.
Well, he's such a good athlete for a center. It's how he's able to succeed despite being one of the smallest fives in the NBA.
And since the halftime break, their offense has just been on another level.
I gotta believe that's something the coach talked to them about at the halftime. They have valued each possession.
And so it's D'Angelo Russell making things He's hit 8 3-pointers. Strong shooting performance in this one. More NBA on 2K Sports right after this. Tonight, as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, just shredding the defense with that feed. Zero chance to stop that.
Well, that's what a great pass will do, right? You love the unselfish play.
Time is running out for this game to become competitive. Jonas Valanciunas out there with Larry Nance. Then there's Devontae Graham, and it's Alvarado in at the one. So that's the group out there for New Orleans.
Here in the second half, they're really focused on stretching the floor.
And guys, boy, when you're hitting, it sure does work. It obviously opens up major options at the offensive end.
Nance. Oh, and Reed with a block. And the ball out of bounds. Touch by Edwards. Now, Rivers has checked in for the Timberwolves. To the inside. Here's Valanciunas. And the dunk by Valanciunas.
Scored the rock at will, but he needs more help from his teammates.
Pass to Rivers. Outside Edwards. Fires the three. Buries it from three. Edwards has got 6 points in the quarter.
Well, don't think twice. Ball touches your hands. You let it go, Anthony Edwards.
That's why they continue to get attacked.
Just an awesome display of athleticism on our AT&T 5G Slam Cam. A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone now. Up top, Reed. And the play-in tournament has been a success, but some debate about whether the stats should count towards postseason stats. Granted, kind of falls in the abyss. How do you think we should reconcile?
Well, BA, first of all, it is the postseason. It's exciting. Everyone's watching. So much is on the line. This is high-pressure elimination games. And yes, there have been some great performances that we've seen in the play-in tournament thus far. So I think these stats should be included in postseason numbers for players. They're really employing a deep range initiative here in the fourth, and it's working.
It feels like they have worked their perimeter game to perfection, swinging the ball, cashing in from the outside. What a performance.
All right, guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for Minnesota.
Yeah, they've collected an impressive number of steals so far, using fast hands to force some turnovers, and then scoring on the other end.
They've also been scoring on the break with how difficult it is to get buckets in the half court. Anytime you can push the ball in transition for easy ones, that's big time.
They've had a slight leg up on the boards and a big leg up on the scoreboard.
Pass to Forbes. Let's the three fly. Sinks it from distance.
They've had a hard time shutting down the three-point shot.
The Pelicans have gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. The three is up. Ooh, poked away. The Pelicans shooting just 38% for this game so far. Here's Graham. Offensive board. Nance can't get it to go.
Boy, in that close, he's almost automatic. Boy, that's pretty good defense. Wow.
A nice shot by Forbes.
Well, the coaching staff loves seeing this kind of playmaking from Austin Rivers, the willingness to share the basketball.
Outside Graham. To halt the run. Deflected!
2 minutes remaining.
Here's Prince.
2 minutes.
And again, it's Minnesota converting.
It's a real skill to be able to move without the basketball. Torian Prince just looking for windows to score, and he does.
Graham, the pass to Valanciunas. And a great assist by Graham as that one goes. Valanciunas has got 12 points in just the second half. Oh, nice finish from the low block. That was good. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've played about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Here's Alvarado. Goes back up. And Valanciunas puts it in. Valanciunas has got 6 points in the quarter.
Now there's the strength we talk about often with Valanciunas. It helps them convert on these physical takes. And what a complete performance we saw from them. A dominant win in every way for the Timberwolves.
And the disparity in the talent was obvious by the end. Sometimes you just don't have enough ammunition to compete.
Yeah, B.A., just a total beatdown. And the next time these teams meet, I can't imagine it'll be any different.
And for the year, this will give them win number 17.
Always good to start a season series off with a W. They show tonight they take this team seriously, and the next two matchups between these two should be fun.
And as it was happening, as it was building, you knew this was a monster game for D'Angelo Russell.
He ran things with precision, great command of the offense, putting his teammates in all the right spots.
High post read. Valanciunas on him. Back to Reed. Pass to Knight. Here's Prince. There's the triple.
And another three for Minnesota.
You gotta give them respect. They're doing everything they can to close this out.
Well, just terrific teamwork. Each guy doing his part. You love what you're seeing from them tonight.
Moore's checked in for Prince. First personal foul. First team foul. Substitution on the court.
32 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter. Here's Daniels. Can they get it? It's tipped. There's 21 seconds left in the game. A nice shot by Knight.
And they knew it wasn't going to be easy to win on the road, but they've controlled the pace on this one.
And sometimes when everyone's rooting against you, it seems to bring the unit closer together. It certainly did tonight.
Making plays at both ends of the floor, and it shows up in the box score.
Well, what I love is the energy they're bringing right now. They're ignoring the scoreboard and playing hard.
So we see the Timberwolves taking the W here. A statement road victory. So impressive.
A statement indeed, B.A.
It was in enemy territory. They controlled the game and took the crowd completely out of it. That's how you win on the road.
Well, now we have some time to check in with Allie LaForce. Allie.
Rudy, you guys came to play tonight. Can you talk about the motivation right from the opening tip?
We just wanted to obviously defensive game, you know, come out ready and make sure we communicate and run back. Because these guys are very talented, and we did a great job.
The communication paid off. Thanks so much.
All right, Allie, thank you. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Allie LaForce, Doris Burke, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Amson alongside our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for watching. We'll see you next time.